we are looking at function graphs. Now, under functions, we have a number of graphs. First of all, we know that a function is given by that function. We can have so many different functions. We can have function of g is equal to y. We can have function of h is equal to y. Now, we want to see the graphs of function. We have so many graphs. We have what we call linear graph. Linear graph is a straight line graph. It's given by a function of mx plus c, where we know m is the gradient and c is the y intercept. The linear graph looks like a straight line, like that, and we know when it looks like this, that's a positive gradient, and when it faces down, that's a negative gradient. We also have what we call a quadratic graph. Now, a quadratic graph function can be given as x squared bx plus c. However, for it to be called quadratic, then the value of a must never be zero. Then anything like that, even it could be g of only x squared, is also a quadratic graph. The quadratic graph is also known as a parabola. Now, how does a quadratic graph look like? Sometimes it can be facing up. Whenever a quadratic graph faces up, it gives us minimum point. But whenever the quadratic graph faces down, it gives us the maximum point. So this is what we call our parabola. We have another type of graph that we call it cubic graph. Now, a cubic graph is given by x cubed plus all other values that can be there. It could be x squared, could be x, and a constant value. However, as long as we have x cubed, then this is a cubic graph. Now, how does a cubic graph present? Cubic graph can appear like a zigzag, or cubic graph can form that turning nature. Now, this nature, it has two turning points. We have one turning point and another turning point. The down one is the minimum and the up one is the maximum. We have another type of graph that we can call exponential. Exponential graph. Now, how does the exponential graph look like? It could be hx is equal to, when the part of the power, there will be an unknown. So whenever we see unknown as part of the power, it represents exponential graph. Now, how does the nature of exponential graph appear? It's usually like an L. The exponential graph is usually like an L. Those are the nature. We also have another very important graph, which is known as reciprocal graph. Reciprocal graph. Now, this is one of the most important graphs that confuses students. Why? First of all, it can have usually unknown is part of the denominator. Sometimes we can have many values, even up. But as long as there is a denominator which is existing as an unknown, then we shall be having a reciprocal graph. Now, under a reciprocal graph, when drawn, it appears as if they are two graphs drawn in one. For instance, there are some of them where the value of x can never be equal to zero. Meaning what? For instance, if I have my graph like this, a graph can appear as if it was going to form a curve, but then one side continues downwards and the other side goes upward. Why? They're diverting from touching the x0 value. So at the end, this looks like one part of the graph and this looks like another part of the graph. On the other hand, the graph could be appearing as if it is going to be a straight line. But then, because it may be supposed not to touch the y-axis, this can turn downwards, and also this can turn downwards. And the result is, they should not cross the x is zero. Now, the end look, this graph will look as if there are two graphs in one, but actually, that is known as one graph, and it is known as a reciprocal graph. Now, how do we draw a graph? Let's have a look at this example. Here we have one example. When you look quickly, the example you are seeing here is a quadratic. Why quadratic? Because we have what we call here x squared minus x plus 5. We are always given a table of value according to our level of coverage. Some can be given, or all the values in the table might not be given. Now, if the table of values are not given, how do you find them? Look at the equation. Y is equal to, on the place of x, you will put the value like that in your calculator. Now, for case, we don't know here. Now, since x is negative 2, we shall get our calculator, open bracket, negative 2, close bracket, square, minus, open bracket, negative 2, close bracket, then minus 5. That will give us 1. So we shall go to our table value and we shall replace there 1. Now, we shall also get 3 and we keep in our table value, keep in our calculator, and then we solve and we get our value. After knowing your values, how do we plot the points? We are given x is negative 3, y is 7. This is our x-axis. X negative 3 is here. We go up till y is 7, keep a mark. Negative 2, we go up till 1. And at negative 1, we drop down till negative 3. At 0, we drop down till 5. At 1, we drop down till 5. At 2, we have negative 3. At 3, we have 1. And at 4, we have 7. After plotting all the points, you get your smooth curve and join the points like this. Now we have our graph. We shall name it y is equal to x squared minus x minus 5. Now this is our parabola, as we can see it. This is how we quickly draw a graph. Let's have another example. When we look at this graph has got a numerator unknown. So quickly we shall understand that this is a reciprocal graph. And it is giving us that here, x will never be equal to zero. That's why we don't have any zero value, and hence our curve will never touch y-axis. Our curve will never touch y-axis. Now, our equation is giving us 2 over x. On the place of x, that's where we shall keep our x values. Now, our first x value we have is 2 divided by, open bracket, negative 1, close bracket, gives us negative 2. So, we shall replace there negative 2. Then, we have 2 divided by, open bracket, negative 0.5, close bracket, giving us negative 4. So we shall replace there with negative 4. That's how we find the values. And on this side, we shall have the other values as you can find. Now, after finding the values, we have to plot the points. You have to be very keen with your scale, because if you mess up the scale, then your graph will not come correct. Let's start with the first value. At negative 4, we have to go down negative 0.5. Now, my scale is 1 centimeter 2. Meaning at that position, I'll have negative 1. Meaning, negative 0.5 will be somewhere here. So I'll place my point there. At negative 3, I will have negative 0.75, which will be also close. Then I'll come to negative 1. At negative 1, I'll go to negative 2. Then at 0.5, I'll go to 4. At 0.2 negative, I'll go down to negative 10. I'll continue this side. At 0.2, it will come up there. And here, at 0.5, it will be 4. At 1, it will be 2. At 2, it will be 1, and at 3, it will be 0.7, and at 4, it will be 0.5. Now, when you join this graph, it will appear in such a way that it is going like that, and like that, and the other side will appear going like this. There we go. Because we didn't have any values at x is 0, that's why this graph is not allowed to touch the y-axis. Finally, we name our graph y is equal to x, 2 over x. And we shall have constructed the graph. This is how we easily construct graphs, as we have discussed. If you have enjoyed, you can like my channel and also subscribe to my channel. My name is Ishengoma. Thank you for watching.